standing ovation. Okay, I'm done. It's good enough, but more can you ask for? So, the title that Mark Skousen picked was Confrontation, My Fights with Donald Trump, Ted Turner, Other Central Planners. So, I guess I'll talk about that. I actually was going to talk about my new project, which started today, which Naomi mentioned. But before I get to that, let me just back up and spend this time talking a bit about my adventure, how I finally, too slowly, woke up to what you people already know, that limited government works better. It was not intuitive to me. I started as a garden variety media person. Typical leftists. At Princeton, they taught me, we know what works now. We can fix poverty. We have experts. We can plan the world. And I became a consumer reporter because I'm a stutterer and I didn't want to be out in politics competing with the people screaming questions. I wanted to do my own thing, so I invented this new field, consumer reporting, and my peers in the media loved it. I won lots of Emmy Awards for doing that. And I enjoyed that. I got my 19 Emmys. There were lots of businesses that deserve being criticized. But eventually I woke up to the fact that business doesn't do as much damage as we consumer reporters do, calling on government to fix it, imposing all these rules. The rules don't work. They just make life more complicated. And it turns out the way to get really rich in America is to treat your customers well. And by and large, the free market works. The good companies grow. They thrive. The bad companies atrophy. The market takes care of itself. But reporters don't get that. And it, as long as I was getting all these awards, I didn't get it either. But I finally started to see it. I started, when I looked more closely, to see that these powerfully pitched arguments from politicians about how they're going to make life better are bullshit. But, you know, you're an oddball group to clap because, and we know we're all oddballs here, but it's a powerful argument. You look at things like OSHA, the Occupational Safety and Health Administration. The head of it under Bill Clinton was fond of showing this chart of how workplace injuries and deaths have dropped since OSHA began. And it's true, look at all the lives that have been saved. This is why they say we need government. The factory owner doesn't care if he kills his workers, he just wants to make money, make a profit. See why we need government? We saved those lives. And that made sense to me. It makes sense to everybody. Except, years later, some researchers bothered to track the safety record and the workplace fatalities from before OSHA began. And you see something different. And this happens everywhere. I mean, OSHA made no difference. We were getting safer all the time, because that's what happens in a free society. As we get smarter, we learn from our mistakes. When someone's injured, you fix the problem. As we get wealthier, we care more about safety and health. Wealthier is healthier. But OSHA and all government, it's like somebody who gets in front of a parade and claims, oh yeah, we led the parade, we controlled the parade, we did it. Government didn't. But people don't get that, and government grows unsustainably, as you know. And so I've made a career of yelling at them and asking them to stop bothering us, stop spending us broke. Yeah, well, I'm failing here. There's so many examples. When I first started doing this, I was at ABC. And I said, let me report on some other things besides just business. Like the Department of Interior had lost, the Bureau Bureau of Indian Affairs, lost $2 billion worth of the Indians' money. Nobody's fired. Nobody ever gets fired in government. I wanted to ask someone at the Interior Department about that, and to my surprise, the Secretary of the Interior agreed. Whoops. That slide is too soon. We should be.
Another expose. It's all in a day's business, I understand. Okay, well, let's...